the push for ecumenical unity, where we even have evangelicals and Muslims coming together saying nice things about each other, that's fine. Probably are some nice things to say about each other. However, what we don't see happening at these conventions would be Christians preaching the gospel to whatever, be it Muslims, be it whoever they're having these ecumenical meetings with. The gospel is left out.
Yes, exactly.
No offense.
No, the gospel is an offense, and we wouldn't want to offend people, especially Muslims. You know, that's the way it's couched. I think I call these Christians silly Christians. I mean, these silly ideas that they're accepting. It's a false premise, for example, the ecumenical movement between Muslims and Christians that has been forwarded by the Yale Divinity School.
Yes.
This is a silly notion based on the idea that the Muslim God is actually the Christian God. First of all, biblically, this is not true, and every Muslim cleric in the world knows it, but it's, of course, the advantage of Islam for Christians to believe otherwise. Frankly, this is simply not true. We cannot dialogue with people based on a false premise, and the whole premise of the Yale Divinity School and its quest to bring Muslims and Christians together, including some of the high-profile pseudo kind of maybe evangelicals that we see out there who have signed on to this idea.
Yes.
It's something that we all need to understand. And we watch the Christian community continue to just follow along blindly saying, oh, isn't this wonderful? We want unity. But let's never forget that unity at the cost of absolute truth, the scriptural truth that we follow, unity at the cost of truth really isn't unity.
Well, the Bible, there's biblical unity. Psalm 133, behold how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell in unity. But then we've got some of these other efforts that are really compromising. And then we've got something that's come along, probably this isn't real recent, but it seems to be gaining speed in your comment on it, and that is the number of denominations that say, well, we don't take all of the Bible literally. We don't take the book of Revelation literally. In other words, they want to allegorize parts of Scripture that God had no intention be allegorized.
We both know as we read the Scripture there are certain things that we don't literally do, like pluck out our eyes, for example.
Right, and the trees don't clap their hands, but
yes, and you know we understand what's being said there. If you go through and you understand how to read the Scripture, you know what's being said there. But when they talk about allegorizing all the things in the Book of Revelation, well, this simply does away with what John saw, and what he is seeing is not an allegory. What he's being shown by the Lord Jesus Himself is not an allegory. And so this is part of liberalism. This was, of course, one of the attacks
Yes.
against the Word of God itself. This means that the serpent really didn't appear to Eve. You know, it's all just a story. It's a fable.
Well, when you do start allegorizing, and folks, if you do have a love for eschatology, Bible prophecy, we will talk about it at length at the event, October 9th, 10th, again, Grace Church, Eden Prairie. There's no cost, by the way. Just show up Friday night, 7 p.m., Saturday morning, 9 to 5, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., but when we start allegorizing the book of Revelation, you know, there goes eschatology completely out the window. That is about, well, I think about a third of the Bible is somehow related, speaking of, referring to a last day generation, which you and I believe that we're in as we speak. But anyway, when we start not taking the Bible literally, the topic of eschatology is completely wiped out in a particular church, which is heartbreaking.
Yes, it certainly is, but these are the perilous times that we live in, where people are certainly lovers of themselves more than God, and we are watching the great falling away take place, and people are trying to form and shape Christianity to be what they want it to be, instead of what God has said in His Word that this faith is all about. And we've got to remember that instead of trying to make Christianity acceptable to the world, we need to convince the world to come underneath the blood covering of Jesus Christ and accept Him and be saved, that they then will be acceptable to God. This is part of the problem inside the emergent movement, the liberalism that we see, and so many of these other movements are all tied together by this idea of trying to make Christianity nice to the world.
Yeah. Well, and then we have all sorts of theologies that have gained prominence too, and time is not going to allow us to get into all of them, Eric, but we've sadly seen the rise of this Only the death of discernment, folks, only the death of discernment could bring about, cause popularity to the theology known as either Kingdom Now or Dominion Theology, and that is that the church is actually going to make the world perfect, and then and only then can the Lord return after the church spends about 10 gazillion years making the world perfect. I'm not sure how many years that's going to take, Eric, but it's not going to happen.
Well, the scripture doesn't teach this. That's the first thing. And I just wonder how many people who went all the way through some of the most popular books that have been out here in the last 20 or 30 years would realize that the end result of some of these very popular Christian books we've seen, and I'm not sure we want to name those without the time to discuss
them.
Yeah,
we don't have that.
Yeah. But anyway, the ideas that are being taught in some of these books, the end result is the Christians are going to take the planet over and we're going to fix everything. And the scripture doesn't teach that. Scripture teaches, sad but true, that things will get darker and darker in the end of the end days. But the real church will get brighter and brighter in the end of the end days. I usually tell people when the street light is on at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, you don't notice it. By 10 o'clock at night, it really stands out. Yeah. As things get darker, the real church shines brighter.
All right, well, these are some of the things that we will be discussing October 9th, 10th. If you want to come on out, again, there's no cost. You can meet Eric Barger, Dr. Ron Rhodes on eschatology, Gary Kah on how the whole globalism effort is absolutely on fast forward. So, my friend, we're going to be seeing you here in a few weeks. Looking forward to it.
That's terrific, Jan. I look forward to seeing everybody at the conference, and thanks for having me on today. God bless you.
All right. Take care. Again, folks, no cost for that particular event, October 9th, 10th, Grace Church, Eden Prairie. Actually, there's a lunch available for a very small cost on Saturday. Again, if you would like to get my print journal, Understanding the Times, there is no cost. You can just, if you're not in my database, please call the following number. You'll get a free DVD if you do so, and that is 763-493-3010. And that is a free DVD along with a print journal, which is free. That's 5 to 6 times a year. Again, all programming done on the weekend goes up on my website. We're trying to shoot now for late Sunday, but give us a little time here because we're still working out some bugs. And if you'd like to become a CD subscriber and get 2 CDs a week of everything we do on Understanding the Times Radio, you can, that's $30 a month, call that same number, 763-493-3010. I know we are living in troubled times, but the Bible is full of good news. And the Bible encourages us to always, well, look up. Our Redeemer draws nigh. The Bible also says in the book of Hebrews, that we are to encourage one another. I'm going to keep beating that drum and ask you to encourage at least 5 people this week because I talk to a lot of people who are really down. Your word of encouragement would help them enormously. In the meantime, would you look back and thank Him? Would you look around and serve Him? Would you look ahead and trust Him? Always look up and expect Him. Jesus is coming again, sooner rather than later. Hey, thanks for listening, and we'll talk to you next time.
If Jan Markell's radio outreach has helped you understand the times, would you consider a tax-deductible donation to Olive Tree Ministries? You can write to Box 1452, that's Box 1452, Maple Grove, Minnesota, 55311. Or call 763-493-3010, 763-493-3010. You also can order and donate safely online at olivetreeviews.org. And thanks for listening to Understanding the Times.